let us solve some questions based on the concept. Exercise 1.5. First question is states that identify whether rational or irrational. So let us see whether this number is rational or irrational. If we simplify this, the square root term gets cancelled out and we get completely a natural number, integer. Hence this is a rational number. Another one which we take is 2 root 7 by 2 root 7. Again on simplification, this gets cancelled out, remaining is 2 by 7. Since it is in P upon Q format, we call this one as a rational number. Next sum that we take, third one, that is root 5 plus root 2 square. Simple, just as application of a plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab. So this will be root 5 square plus root 2 square plus 2 into root 5 root 2. So this will be 5 plus 2 plus 2 root 10, that is 7 plus 2 root 10, that is the answer. Next we have law of exponents. This is again very important concept. Rules or laws of exponent involves a to the power n dot. When bases are same, powers can be added. Please remember, a to the power m to the power n, then these powers will be multiplied, m into n. A to the power m upon a to the power n will be a m minus n. And fourth one, a to the power m dot b to the power m can be combinedly written as a b to the power m. Then a to the power 0 is 1. Anything raised to the power 0 is always 1. Then 1 upon a to the power n can be written as a to the power minus n. Let us see how does this works. We take examples and discuss. So 6 to the power 2 dot 6 to the power 3. It becomes 6 to the power 3 plus 2, 5. You can cross check this. Then 3 to the power 2, the power 3. It becomes 3 to the power 6. Again you can cross check, you will get the same answer. Then 4 to the power 5 upon 4 to the power minus 2. This can be 4 to the power 5. And when denominator goes to the numerator, it becomes negative. So negative of minus 2. So 4 to the power 5 plus 2, and this becomes 4 to the power 7. Furthermore, for this one, let us say 3 to the power 0 dot 3 to the power 2. So it becomes 3 to the power 0, 3 to the power 2 and 4 to the power 2. It becomes 3 into 4 whole raised to the power 2, that is 12 to the power 2. 4 to the power 0 is 1, or if you write 1 upon 5 whole to the power 0, that is again 1. Anything raised to the power 0, it is always 1. 1 upon 4 can be written as 4 to the power minus 1. In denominator, the power is positive here. As soon as it is taken to the numerator, the power becomes negative. Similarly, 1 upon 5, it can be written as 5 to the power minus 1. Let us see some questions from exercise 1.6. First, second one, it says 32 to the power 1 by 5. How will I simplify this? Convert it into its basic factors. So those factors can be found out by this method. So 32 can be written as 2 to the power 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the other 1 upon 5. As per the laws of exponent, when the bracket opens, the numbers get multiplied. It leaves 2 to the power 1, which is nothing but 2. This is the answer. Another question we take, 1 upon p cube raised to the power 7. Taking denominator to the numerator, power will become negative. As soon as bracket opens, the power will get multiplied. So minus 21. This is the answer. Here we end chapter 1.